down. Boom, boom, fuck it, I'm a shot like what? Fuck, 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 shut this club down. You bitches ain't next. Say, do you watch my grand movie next? Yeah, one look a boom, girl, I chase them checks. Big patty guy straight from the jacks to the jet. Excuse you, bitch, we grind for this money. And these broke niggas can't get nothing from me. Don't say me a rude guy, yeah, I'm taking shit. Lay a nigga down if you don't want no more. Tell me how to pop my pussy on his head. Bitches, you say no, I'm running to this money. Never take the water, left the wood.
Post with a blood clot camera, me clean and come out. Instagram back girl and a tight she call out. See me in a real life, I have to shut up your mouth. My money low, your back dry like it a cut through the drought.
Why you make me, bitch, I make you rats. Looking like a store, got stores on my cellar. This a great phone, you ain't got the peso. Shit in his face, head, I'm busting like a Draco. I never let him stay, oh, send him on his way, yo. I know he a rookie, so this pussy that he chased for. $100 your dash, the money your cash. Be a lifesaver, spend his shit on a bag. I'm cash, only cause I stay mine. Just to see my ways now. Chair. Yardi in Jamaica say he feeling me like grill. I be taking trips while you bitches taking L's. Checks in the mail, you better watch your mail. Or I send him home broke, bitch, your bill money missing. Me and Spice out here getting real money, bitches.
I'ma get it, I'ma get it, I'ma get it. Pop that ass, drop down if you with it. I'ma get it, I'ma get it, I'ma get it. Pop that ass, drop down if you with it. I'ma get it, I'ma get it, I'ma get it.
My foot up on your wish list. Money a fly, every day a elastic band me twist. Earring to the chain, no way, check my wrist. See, I don't know if you'll understand me. So let me calm down, speak more clearly. The things that I buy, bitch, wait for a fairy. Or a safe couple bucks, then you might just barely.
I'ma get it, I'ma get it, I'ma get it. Pop that ass, drop down if you with it.
What's goodie? That was my jam. Like, that was really my jam. I'm super excited to have part two of my Trans Can't Be Erased special edition. We got Rio in the building. It's going to be super lit. We're going to talk about all things trans. We're going to talk about his transition, how he got started and what side effects, all unfiltered. If you saw part one, you will it was serious. So we're going to do a little recap in part one, and then we're going to bring you forward to what we did, what we're going to talk about now. But of course, I got to let you know, of course, who are we sponsored by? We sponsored by Dig the Kicks. You already know, this is Dad's hat. AD from Love & Hip Hop Hollywood sponsors the show. They have joggers, sweatsuits, t-shirts, pants, hats, they got it all. It's super lit. Make sure you go to that website, digthekicks.dtk.com. And when you're there and you pick all your items, make sure you get that 15% off by typing Royal in that promo code. We also are collabing with SwagNationMagazine.com, which is the number one independent artist magazine in the nation. It's also distributed in 5 other countries. Did you hear me? 5 other countries. So I need all my artists to come and hit me up with your best 16 bars, because we got iSpits coming to you. iSpits is the first online live cypher competition where our champ, our longest reigning champ, is going to be entered in that magazine for a spotlight. So it's going to be super lit. Your brand is going to be exposed to the world. It's just going to be an amazing thing. So make sure y'all be prepared for that. January 10th, we coming with iSpit. So make sure y'all stay tuned for that. Now, let's get started. I'm so excited for this interview. Like I said, we're about to get down and dirty. And for all these, all my new viewers tuning in, thank you guys. Make sure y'all share this live. Make sure y'all like, y'all comment. If y'all in here now, what y'all need to do is share this live. This is a great, great interview. This is a great message that we need to talk about. We need to talk about the trans community, especially now with Trump doing what he's doing, the stupidity of our president. Not, you know what I mean? I would say not even my president, your president. You feel me? And we just need to have this conversation, because if more people have this conversation, then we'll be better educated to be less ignorant. So without further ado, bringing out Rio. Super exciting, guys. Hey, look, ready. Okay. I like that. You ready this time? Look, had him charged up.
Yeah, I'm good now.
What's up? What's up?
Nothing, bro. I've been waiting for this for like some days.
I know. We've been waiting. Everybody's been waiting. So many people have been like, when are you coming for part two? When are you coming for part two? Let me tell you, part one was epic. When I tell you, it was epic. Yeah. It definitely was a great conversation. I'm sorry for all those people who missed it the first time, but you can definitely go watch it. I do want to recap a little bit on part one, but before we get there, where can everybody find you on social media?
Rio Wade. Let me see. _AskMaria. Even though I ain't changed my name yet, don't judge.
We're going to talk about all of that. Guys, for you.
Man, I'll jot that shit down later. But anyway.
Rio Wade. Exactly. That's what you can find. Before we continue, I do want my viewers to know that this is an unfiltered. We had a conversation already. So I want the viewers to know that this is not no bashing. This is not no craziness. This is uncut, unfiltered education. The stuff that, you know, it's just a conversation that is just needed to have. You feel what I'm saying? Just understanding our community and knowing what the trans community is about, knowing what's going on, and just tapping into their world to just getting into their mind. So I just want people to know, because, you know, some of the questions we're going to be asking is because it's a lot of stereotypes and stigmas behind the trans community. So we're going to be clearing a lot of things up, and we're going to be asking the questions that a lot of people are scared to ask, but we're going to get it out there so that you guys can be educated, and even myself. So let's get into it. So going back into last conversation, we were kind of talking a little bit more. We was kind of getting to know you and talking about your life of growing up and feeling like, not yourself growing up. So just to recap real quick, explain to the viewers now, what was that emotion like, knowing that, okay, I'm biologically a female, but I don't feel this way?
As far as that, you know, it was difficult. I'm not even going front and say that it wasn't, because me, personally, you know, growing up, I knew, you know what I'm saying, that, you know, something was going on, because, hey, I'm out here skating with the boys, out here with my shirt out, doing all this extra bull, or whatever the case may be. As far as my family and everything, they was just like, oh, you know, it's a phase, she'll go through it, or whatever the case may be. And, you know, my mom, she kind of knew, you know what I'm saying? My mama knew from day one, you know what I'm saying?
Mama always knows.
When she handed me that Barbie doll, and I looked at her like she was crazy. And she was like, okay, so this clearly ain't the toy that I'm supposed to be giving her, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So she gave me the G.I. Joe or whatever the case it is, the skateboard, the basketball. And she was like, okay, my child's gonna turn out gay, you know what I'm saying?
So she thought at that time it was just, you know, my child's gonna be a lesbian.
Yeah, it was until later on, you know, when I came to her, I was like, you know, Ma, how would you feel if I went on ahead and transition? She pretty much gave me the one-top shot, the one line, it's your life, you do what you want to, you know.
So I support you either way. She grew up with an accepting, my mother
was very accepting. My mother's been accepting since day one. It was my grandmother that raised me that, you know, she had the hard time with it because, like I said, I grew up in an all-white household. So, you know, in Random in North Carolina, anyway, if anybody knows where that is, it's like 95. I don't want to be rude to my hometown, but it's like 85% of the people that stay in my hometown is white. That other small percentage is black people.
Okay.
You understand what I'm saying? So it's like, it's difficult because it's like, okay, you know that your family stay here, but at the same time, you got to realize that I didn't grow up hanging around my family or none of that either. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Because my dad wasn't like completely in my life physically, like every day and none of that. I didn't hang around my family on my dad's side and none of that. I kind of stayed to myself, you know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. So like even when I got in high school and, you know, I decided to fully come out, you know what I'm saying? I had people all through middle school telling me, yo, we know you gay. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to lie to us. We know you gay. And I would lie to you. I'm not gay. What you mean? I'm not gay.
You were playing like the tomboy role. Were you dressing like baggy clothes and boy clothes and stuff?
I started dressing like that eighth grade, ninth grade. For a long time, I wasn't allowed to dress the way that I wanted to.
Oh, okay.
So it's kind of like I didn't have a choice, you know what I'm saying? But to me, it was kind of like, man, how do these people know that I'm gay? You know what I'm saying? Because it's like I would get on the bus, go home, whatever the case may be, and, you know, this one particular person, she had just graduated. And, you know, it was the end of the summer. We about to go out of school. We get on the bus to ride home for the last time. And she had graduated. And she came to me before she got off the bus. She was just like, because, of course, you know what I'm saying, I didn't have a nickname then. She was just like, Maria, I know you gay. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to hide it. I'm like, well, why do you say that? She was like, I've been around you all this time. You know what I'm saying? I peep what you do. You look at girls like you know what I'm saying? You're attracted to feminine dudes or whatever the case may be. And I'm like, nah. But later on, you know what I'm saying, when I first came out and put it out there, she was like, I'm glad that you finally became very open and honest with yourself. And right, I was like, right. Well, it wasn't a part of the matter of me being honest with myself. It was the fact of the matter knowing what the reaction was going to be, you know, from
you
my
was
friend.
Scared of what everybody else's reaction was going to be.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
So I know a lot of people just got taken back, like I did the first time I heard this, the last time we had interviewed. You know, you did mm-hmm. say that, you know, your friend realized that you were looking at feminine boys. So explain to the viewers that don't understand, you know, the concept.
Well, because,
so you're attracted to feminine boys as well as females.
Yeah, I wouldn't say that. You know, I ain't haven't really been with a female in a long time. But as far as, you know, the feminine boys and stuff like that, my first time, I'm not gonna lie, my first time actually looking at a feminine boy was in elementary school, but I didn't pay no attention because you're like,
right.
I'm just like, oh, you know, well, I didn't know that he was like, he was gay or anything like that, but he turned out gay until later on when I got in middle school, high school, and I see him and I'm like, the dude name was Deshaun. I see him and I'm like, hey, what's up, Deshaun? He was like, oh, hey, girl. I'm like, wait, you're gay? He was like, yeah, I've been gay. I'm like, oh, okay, you know, that's cool, whatever. He was like, and clearly you gay too. I'm like, okay, and you know what I'm saying? Just like, I mean, we connected, we cool and everything. Like, I just seen him like a couple years back or whatever, and he, I agree. And he was just like, you know, I'm glad to see that you're finally happy, living your truth and doing what you want to do with your life. And I was like, yeah, I mean, it sucks that it took me a while, but you know, hey, it is what it is.
Right. So this is the shout out to Flex Jones. It's a good man.
Flex Jones.
he wrote Sexuality Doesn't Define Gender. Now, although I do know that and I do agree with that statement, but for the people, again, for the people watching and for the new viewers coming in, I want you not to be offended or feel offense to this live. I'm going to be asking questions. This is an unfiltered kind of take away from the stigma. So I'm kind of asking all those stigma questions that people are kind of ignorant. So this is an education. This is stuff to figure out what's going on and just to get educated for everyone else, especially. So explain that, Rio. Sexuality doesn't define gender. What does that mean for you?
To me, sexuality and gender is way two different things. As far as sexuality and me personally, I feel like sexuality, it's relationship wise, bedroom things, all that other stuff. That's something totally different from being classified as your gender. I classify myself as a male, so therefore it doesn't matter if I'm attracted to another male, you know what I'm saying? Or I'm attracted to a girl or whatever the case may be. Bottom line, point blank, period. I just feel like at the end of the day, people be sitting here putting stigmas on the gay lifestyle, period. Whether it's sexuality or, you know, who you want to be with or your gender or whatever the case may be. Thank you. Whatever the case may be, it has nothing to do with any of that. Like, me personally, okay, because it's very clear that people nowadays, they have a problem with seeing, you know, a trans dude dating a feminine man or, you know what I'm saying, or a lesbian dating a feminine dude or whatever the case may be.
So is it people are...
They're judgmental.
Is it because they don't see it often, so they don't understand it, or is it just a judgmental thing?
Me personally, feeling, being that I've been doing this for a while, I think it's judgmental because people put it in their own perspective of what the gay life is supposed to be, and the girls are supposed to date the girls, and the boys are supposed to date the boys. But when they see that the stud and a feminine boy is together, they're like, oh, what the fuck? Or if they see the trans man and the feminine boy together, they're like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying?
Right,
and I'm
right.
Like, why is you doing all that? Because at the end of the day,
I'm not going to lie. And everybody that's watching, please share this live. Let's get this information out there so that the world can, you know, figure something out so that we can all come together. But I'm not going to lie. Back in the day, I and this may be really ignorant, but back in the day, I used to be like that. I used to be that person, that stigma. I used to be that person to be like, oh my God, like, why are they doing extra shit? Like, why can't they just blah, blah, blah? But that's because I was uneducated and I didn't know, you know? So when I'm going to be real, and this might be crazy, but what got me into my education in wanting to learn more was the Caitlyn Jenner show. And
man,
I watched
that show. I'll be honest with you. I wasn't even looking at it like that because my eyes was on gay men since I turned 18 years old. So what could you possibly tell me? Like, same thing I told my mama. What could you? Girl, I know.
Well, I guess you're right. I guess you're right. But my whole thing is like I said, I didn't understand it completely after that show, but what it did was it made me open my eyes to be like, okay, now I'm intrigued to understanding. And that's when I realized that sexuality didn't define your gender or vice versa. Yeah. You feel me? I realized it's that right. Because you feel a certain gender doesn't mean that you have to match the sexuality.
Right.
So going into that, you said you're not attracted to women anymore, or you never really was? Like, what is that?
I'm not going to say that I wasn't never attracted to women, because I was. The thing about it now is that I have, you know, I was and been dealing with feminine dudes. So it's kind of like, you know, if a girl was to approach me, I probably wouldn't know how to act. I would probably find it weird. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm like, well, what you talking to me for? You know what I'm saying? And like, especially when the people that know me, this, you know what I'm saying, they've been knowing me for a hot minute, they know that I'm real quick to be like, yo, is she talking to me or what? You know what I'm saying? Because I'm like, I can clearly recall myself talking to this gay boy over here, but she talking to me now. So, hey.
So as far as and as far as feminine boys, are we talking? Feminine hair? Are we talking just feminine characteristics, or are we talking about features as well? Like, is it like a personality thing, or is it a physical thing?
Both.
When we say feminine, is both? So
both. Because me personally, I like my dudes to be, you know what I'm saying? They need to have some type of femininity. But I also like my dudes to have some masculinity, too. Like, if you take your masculinity in the bedroom, you feel me?
Right, right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Take that
Wait, you see? Wait. That makes me have another conversation. You see what I'm talking about?
Yeah, that's type of dude I am.
So
take that
you
to
like
the bedroom.
To be dominated,
you feel me?
In the bedroom.
You said
like,
what?
You like the masculinity to come out in the bedroom. And
all
in
day.
The street is give me the feminine.
I mean,
not
you know what I'm saying? Give me
street,
some type give me some type of feminine. I'm not asking you to be like, I'm one of the girls. I'm not asking you to do that.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? But I'm saying, like, don't make it be like, you know what I'm saying? Don't give that straight dude vibe off to
okay,
me.
Okay, okay,
in public,
I get you.
You
I
feel
get
me?
You.
Because, like I told you from the beginning, that straight dude shit blew out the door. That's not what I'm attracted to.
So that brings me into getting into, you know, sex and what sex is to you. And please stop me if it gets too much.
Nah, you good.
And again, for the new viewers that we got a lot of new people coming in, we're having an open, honest conversation, unfiltered. We had a conversation before this, so we know what's going to be talked about, and we both have an agreement to this, and this is for education purpose, and Rio just explaining his life, to be honest with you, helping to help somebody else in theirs. So keeping the conversation going.
Like,
going
what you
wanna know? Sex. Born with sex,
right? As,
because sexuality doesn't define gender. What does that mean? That you still have your female tendency traits to where you want to receive only thrust?
All
I mean, like, how does that work? How does that
what
work?
You mean all the time. That boy, I think a mean dick. The fuck you mean? But at the end of the day,
hello?
You know what I'm saying? I'm the type of dude where I receive and I give. You know what I'm saying? Period. Like, it just depends on what the person that I'm dating likes. Like, I'm the type of person, like, I'll be like, yo, babe, you want your ass ate? Because I'm all for it. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
No, do not log off. Do not log off.
Wait, what's going on? Flex, we're gonna talk about his transition and how long he's transitioning, and all of that good things and stuff like that. And figure out some stuff. I don't know what happened with his, but I think it logged off or something. I love Rio. He is so open and honest, and I respect him so much. And I love him for doing this. We're going to see if we get him right back on. Thank you, Tanya. Shout out to you. Love you. Key is in the building. Shout out to Key. I think his phone logged off, so we're trying to get him back. So as soon as he logs back on, we're going to get him back up here. Sorry, guys. But we're having such a good conversation. What do you guys think? Please comment below. If we do have any trans in the building, please shed some knowledge. If you have something that is not you agreed with, you know, something that is different for you, please, we love to know if you're open and honest. This is not a forceful interview, so everything is voluntary. And yeah, shout out to my Royals for tuning in each and every week. I love you guys so much. Because of you, y'all make a lot of things possible for me. Y'all really do. Y'all got me. I don't know if y'all seen, but they're working on our cover of our magazine, of the magazine. I'm so excited. Oh, it's going to be so lit. Rio's back. We're going to get Rio back up here.
Your iPhone shut the hell off when it gets too hot.
Miss you too.
Anyway. Like I said, I give and receive. I am a very open person. Like, in the situation that I'm in now, you know what I'm saying? It's a very hot 1, 2, 3. Like, if you like that, then I'm going to give it to you. Like, period. And, of course, I'm going to receive. I'm definitely going to receive because that is the go-to. But I mean, it just depends on what my partner like, because I'm into all that. Like, I would do my partner, you know what I'm saying? But not everybody like a strike game, so you know what I'm saying? You gotta use your mouth and make it work.
So I got a question from JJ Jones. I want to understand, it says, I want an understanding on what Rio identifies as in terms of sexuality. No the gender doesn't go hand in hand, but would you be a gay male?
Basically, that's what I'm considered as a gay man.
Yes. You'll be considered as a gay man.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay, so we had a... Go ahead.
Brian, hold on one second. Brian, I need you to comment in the box, please, so that I know that you are here. Thank you.
So we had a question before. I want to get into a little bit more about your transition. Let's start off with how long have you been transitioning?
Right now, I am at a month and 1 week.
A month and 1 week.
So
that is dope. That's dope. So what is that process of transitioning, and how does it? How do you get started in that process? So if somebody wanted to say I was trans and I didn't know how, so what is that process?
I'm gonna be honest with you. Starting the process for me was very difficult because, for one, I don't have insurance. And so it's like I have to pay everything out of pocket. I'm not gonna lie, like most trans men do, and say that it's an easy process, because it's definitely not. And whoever told you that is a fucking liar, period, because it's not. Like, I personally, I'm just going to say the bill that I am sitting on right now is almost $1,000 to, and that's just to do my blood work, check my counts, and get prescribed the testosterone. Mind you, I still got to go back to the doctor in February just so she can check my levels and prescribe me some more. So that's going to be a whole extra cost, you know what I'm saying? But I have my own time limit to pay on it. So that's the good thing. But as far as starting your transition, it's difficult, because if you are not sure, for one, that that's what you want to do, then you're going to have a hard time.
They're asking, what's your Cash App or PayPal? So type your Cash App down there. So if people want to support you in your journey, they can. Please, guys, if y'all can support him, this is what we need to do. Support our community. If we support our community the way we support Beyonce and them, do you know where we will be? Support. Support. And shout out to Tanya for suggesting that. That is really dope. That is really, really dope.
Anyway, it's like, it's not an easy process, though. You know, it's been plenty of trans men that I spoke to, you know, about starting my process. I spoke to Flex Jones. I spoke to a bunch of other people. And, you know, they gave me pointers and, you know, tried to help me out the best way that they could. I don't know if you know who Mac is. He's an entertainer. White guy, trans man, spoke to him, you know, they gave me all these different doctors, but at the end of the day, it was up to me to decide. You know what I'm saying? Like, as far as price wise, you know what I'm saying? I could have went to Winston, I could have went to Chapel Hill or anywhere, but you know, I am in my own personal situation, where, you know, I've been going through life struggles, period, you know what I'm saying? From losing everything to working my way back up to getting on my feet and things like that. So, you know, it can be overwhelming, but the only reason that it's not overwhelming for me is because at the end of the day that I know that I have friends and family that will support me and help me out the best way that they can, even if it's not financially. And then on top of that, you know, hello, Jesus is the beholder of everything, and he has everything in control.
Hello. So share this live, guys. Make sure y'all sharing this live.
I don't really stress too much, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, I fucked with people that fucks with me.
I know that's right.
So
I know that's right.
So, you know what I'm saying? I'm getting to the point in my life where it's like, I don't have time for nobody's bullshit. If you can't fuck with me the way that I fuck with you, then we don't need to be friends and none of that shit. It's as simple as a matter of fact, like when I had my car. Now that I don't got no car, if you can't come whip me up when I whip your ass around, it's done. Period.
Period. Hello. That's facts. That's facts. So I had another question going back to your sexuality and your preference. They stated, do you feel like after your transition, your sexual preference will change?
No. Not to be honest with you, no. I'm still gonna like. I'm still gonna like family boys. I'm still gonna like dick.
Hello, that's right.
I mean, I'm chilling.
Oh, can I ask you this? Oh my God, I want to ask you this. I don't know if this is so. Yeah. It's gonna get a little crazy. So, okay, you like dick, right? So, if dating.
Oh, don't make me blush. Don't make me blush.
While dating a feminine man or a man that is, you know, I guess verse, whatever, does the intercourse happen within the vagina or within the ass?
Listen, Flex, you a fool.
What's that emoji?
Being that the person that I talk to, that, or you know what I'm saying, the person that I'm conversating is on here, I'm not going to say that, I wouldn't do the ass thing, but listen, I've been tried it plenty of times, and I'm still trying to figure out how y'all motherfuckers be taking it straight out the asshole, because that shit hurts, okay? And maybe it's just because I don't get fucked in the ass either. You know
people.
What I'm saying? So maybe. Maybe it's because I don't get fucked in the ass, and people don't play with my ass, right, or whatever the case may be. But I mean, I'm not gonna say that I wouldn't do it, because I definitely would. But you know, that's something that we have to work towards. And but you know, it's a two-way street. I'll take it in either way.
That's right. Look, and again, stop me when it's too much, but at the same time, you know what this is, and we're just having a conversation. Somebody asked.
Yeah, this is an open conversation.
Somebody asked.
Listen, this is an open conversation. I don't take.
And actually, for the people that don't know, we're personal friends already, so this is not nothing that like we.
Yes.
So we're gonna talk after this to talk about this. So, but I got a question by Nisha Brown. If you like dick, how are you going to fully transition? So explain to the people that don't understand that. And this is why we have this conversation.
I'm going to go ahead and cut that right down the slides and let you know, was that a boy or a girl?
I feel like it was a female. Let me double check, though. Yeah, a female. Nisha Brown.
Well, let me go ahead and tell you something real quick, shorty, and enlighten you on the transition world. Just because you take dick don't make you no less of a man, whether you are female to male or male to female or whatever. It don't make you no less of a person, okay? And like for me myself, I'm transitioning, but I'm not doing bottom surgery because I don't feel the need to do bottom surgery because I like my parts, okay? I'm just not comfortable with, you know, what's the word that I'm looking for? I'm not gonna say I'm not comfortable with my appearance, but my appearance is not complete.
Right. It doesn't match what you feel inside.
Right. So what do you date a trans woman? Done that. Been there, done that.
Been there, done that. What, JJ, I wanted to know. Are you sick? Okay, so they answered that question. No. So do you... They said, "Do you give oral? Do you give oral sex to men?" Duh. Hello.
If you my man and you want your dick sucked, I'm gonna suck the shit out of it. The fuck you mean?
Look, I love him. I swear to God. You know what it is? We need a raw, uncut conversation like this because for all the ignorant questions that are happening, and it's no offense to nobody here, but there's a lot of ignorant people out here.
Oh, wait a minute. Jasmine Masters.
Yes, Jazz. Shout out to Jasmine Masters. She is a good friend of the show. We love you.
I didn't want to look like no sissy ass drag queen or nothing, or none of that. Like, but Jasmine Masters is everything. Y'all should check her out. Real talk. If you haven't been or talked to Jasmine Masters, you need to get on board. Anyway. Okay, I wasn't trying to offend you. I was just wondering about the bottom section. No offense at all. Like I said, I just want you to understand that, you know, whether you have surgery or not, it doesn't define you as a human being. y'all are funny to me. But that's it. You know what I'm saying?
All right. Well, so let's continue with the transition conversation. So you said a month and a week. So What is that like, that process of first starting the transition? Does it affect your body a lot?
Yes. I'm going to tell you right now, like, I don't know if... I mean, of course, you're going to know it because you talk to me and you know that my voice is changing already. But... as far as everything else, I'm a little up and down at times because of the simple fact, you know, transitioning is, it can be difficult. Right now, my main thing that I am going through is, you know, my period cutting all the way off. So it's not like I still spot bleed every now and then.
Let me tell you something. I'm sure there's females out there that want that to stop. What's funny? I just had a conversation with a cisgender female, and that she was telling me like in depth of the period process, the PMS process, and I was like, oh no, I could not.
Yeah. It's like, as far as that, I still spot bleed. I'm pretty sure every trans man has discharges. I have those a little bit more often. So it's like, I'm busting a nut, but I'm not really busting a nut.
Like,
you know what I'm saying?
You get the sensation.
And, yeah. And then it's like, my main problem right now is I have a high sex drive and I get sexually frustrated because of the simple fact that I'm not doing that type of stuff right at this second. So, I mean, it is what it is, but you know, I got somebody to wait. Girl.
Read out loud for my future viewers.
No, I'm talking about your buddy, my pal. He's talking about, yes, it's going to be good.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, but that's about it. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, I don't really have any complications other than my face is breaking out and my face itches, and that's about it.
So with your body changing with the testosterone and stuff, and you say you're sexually frustrated, is it confusing to feel what you feel, or do you know what you're feeling because things are working in your body?
It's a matter of I know what I feel and I can't get it right.
Got you. So what?
Because I had to
wait. What are certain side effects that people that are you're going through?
Me personally, like right now, I can say that I wasn't a very blunt person. I don't really express my feelings or anything like that. But now that I'm on testosterone, it's kind of opening me up more. Sometimes I think I say a little too much. Sometimes I'm a little too blunt. And at this point, I'm just at a point where I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Like, for instance, it's somebody that I like, but, you know, I'm not putting their names out because I don't tell my business or whatever the case may be. I told them straightforward what it was, what it is, and what it's going to be.
I know that's
it's
right.
As simple as that. And, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, I'm in a point where I am starting to get older. I'm not getting no younger. I've been through a couple life lessons, you know what I'm saying? Trying to figure out what people that are in my life, if they're here for a season or if they're permanent. And, you know, me personally, you know, I'll try to take it one step at a time to, you know, kind of prepare myself for what I'm about to be going through, because I know that me transitioning is going to open my eyes a lot to figure out, you know, who I am as a person, and let alone, you know, what emotions or what I'll be going through. You know what I'm saying? Like my emotions and stuff and the things that I go through. So it's like I try to have that one particular person that's always going to be in my corner no matter what. So that way I don't have a hard time, or, you know what I'm saying? Or I don't end up being like other people, you know, trying to commit suicide or whatever the case may be.
Do you go to therapy?
I actually do go to therapy. I will be going back to therapy in February to talk to my doctor, you know, to see what I need to do and to go on about my top surgery. But other than that, I mean, I'm pretty all right. I don't really have no, you know, no mixed emotions or nothing like that. But when I'm upset, I'm pretty sure everybody can tell when I'm upset. So, I mean, it doesn't last long.
You're very attractive now. Do you?
Oh, thanks. I've never thought of it that way.
You're very attractive now. Going through this transition, you know, is going to define certain features and is going to give that masculine quality that you want, which is going to put you in the GQ magazine. Let me tell you. Are you happy that this transition is happening this way? Are you confident? Are you worried about all the swarm of people that's gonna come your way? Because you're gonna have a lot of people come your way.
I'm gonna say it like this. And I'm only gonna say it once. If you wasn't fucking with me before I was Rio, I'm not fucking with you, period. You know what I'm saying? If you ain't try to holler at me when I was Maria, don't try to holler at me when I'm Rio, because I'm not with the shit. You know what I'm saying? Because
you're gonna be fucking shit up out here. I know you know that.
Okay.
Look,
and
I know that's right. Look, you know it.
And by the time somebody try to talk to me, it's already going to be shut down because it's already somebody else in my life. So,
catch. Catch all of that.
Period.
Catch all of that. So I want to get a little bit into what's going on in this world and what's your take on what's going on. So, of course, our crazy-ass, dumb-ass president had put a thing out there saying that, which is going to start, if it goes passes through, it's going to start with federally funded schools where they're not going to allow you to identify. They're going to identify you as your genitals. So, for example, you that don't want to have your bottom surgery, if you was to go to a federally funded school, university or whatever, that they wouldn't consider you Rio, they would consider you Maria. So what is your take?
Okay,
what is your take on that and what's going on?
I'm gonna be honest with you. I had this conversation with one of my trans friends, and JJ, mind your business and don't worry about who the person in my life is, okay? You little nosy ass brat. But anyway, I actually had this conversation with a trans friend of mine, and he was telling me the same thing, and like I told him, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't matter who or what law goes where or what goes what, because just because my ID says female and I haven't changed my name, that doesn't, once again, that doesn't define me as a trans man, because all that extra stuff that we got going on in the government, that is for the government only. Not for me. That doesn't affect me in my everyday life. What you got written down on a piece of paper don't affect me in my everyday life. Know that. You know what I'm saying? So if I was to go over here and you want to address me by Maria because that makes you comfortable and you think it's funny or whatever the case may be, do that. I'm going to let you have your life do that, because at the end of the day, I am living my truth and my appearance speaks for me and who I want to be. Not no piece of paper, not what that name says on the ID or none of that. I could care less.
That's beautiful that you look at it like that. And unfortunately, there's a lot of people that don't look at it like that, but that is beautiful that you look at it like that, because you're right in the sense where you define who you are regardless of what. Because if you look at it, it's like the same thing
right,
of someone calling someone ugly or someone calling someone out their name. It's up to you if you want to accept what they call you or not. So I do agree with you when you say, you know, that doesn't define you. But I can say it today is not going to affect you. It won't affect it, but tomorrow it can. And that's why we have to stand together to make a stop and make a stand to things like this, because what's written down on that piece of paper is going to trickle down into your everyday life to where you don't have no more programs or no more assistance to get your medication or no more, or they ban the medication altogether or what, and then what, or there's no therapy for, you know, counselors, no, none of that, whatever case. So you have to realize that.
Which that is perfectly understandable. And, you know, like I said, we looked at it that way too. But the way that we are going now, like I said, there's no need to dwell on it right now because it hasn't got that far yet. You know what I'm saying? So my only thing is, like I said, you know, if you know who you are as a person, why are you worried about what everybody else thinks?
And that's facts, though. That's where it lies.
You know what I'm saying? And that's just how I look at it. And to answer your question, I don't know, what is it? Kalani? Is that it? Is that how you say it, Kalani? I will probably marry a gay man.
Hello.
And more for the community and support the LGBT community.
I do agree. I mean, I do agree. I think what we got to start doing in order for things to change is stop separating the L, the G, the B, and the T, and realize that we are one community. And if we support one another and stand together, we will realize how strong and powerful we really are.
Right.
And that's
right.
Facts.
You said Kalani asking for himself. Child. Y'all are funny to me. But you know, it is what it is. And that is totally correct, Flex. The only thing that separates us is our gender, which I mean, I don't see nothing wrong with it. I think it's cool that we got our own little clique. You know what I'm saying?
You know what? Growing up, I used to be upset that I was gay, but I learned to love that I was different from everyone else. But now it became, gay is like a fucking trend. Like, it's like a style or something. And
yeah. I'm be honest with you. I think some people, they just want to be gay because they see everybody.
It's a style. It's a trend. Like, it's a trend to people.
It's like, I know people that I went to school with, they was never gay. But then all of a sudden I see them and they like, oh, hey, Rio, or whatever the case may be. I'm like, you ain't gay. So I don't even know why you put on the front.
So give me something, a closing statement that you will want the world to know that they don't know, and just generally about the trans community that is really stigmatized still. Like, what is something that, you know, you can close out with?
You're so sweet, JJ. But anyway, I feel like, you know what I'm saying, if you want to be transgender, then go ahead. You know what I'm saying? There's no stigma. There's no limit to it. You can do what you want to. As far as being transgender and in the gay community, it's okay. You know what I'm saying? Like I would tell my brother, you know what I'm saying? It's okay to do what you want to do, because at the end of the day, this is your life. You have to live it. Your mother's not living it for you. Nobody's living it for you. Nobody can make you do anything. You know what I'm saying? So as far as my closing statement, I don't really have a closing statement, because I wish everybody the best, and I want them to do what makes them happy, period. Whether it's you're gay and you want to be with a girl, or a boy that want to be with a girl, or a trans man that want to be with a boy, or whatever the case may be, just do you. Because at the end of the day, I wouldn't want nobody else to tell me how to live my life. You know what I'm saying? And just like my friend said a couple of years ago on that bus, I can't wait for you to be honest with yourself. Be honest with yourself, because you will make it a lot farther in life. And you will be a lot happier if you're honest with yourself. And, you know, to all my high school friends and all the people that knew that I was gay, I appreciate you in every way. And you guys impact my life more than you will ever know. And, you know what I'm saying, the people that I grew up with, the people that I've been in a relationship with, or any of that, I appreciate everybody, because if it wasn't for all these people in my life, I wouldn't be who I am today.
You better preach it. You better preach, yes.
You know what I'm saying? If it wasn't for my grandma coming in that bathroom, busting in the door, asking me, are you gay? You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be an open person that I am today, and I wouldn't be the nicest and the most humblest person that I am today. And because of the situations that I've been through in my life, and because of the current situation that I am going through right now, it has made me so much of a better person. And, you know, as far as my maturity level, it has matured me a lot. It's also, you know, taught me that, you know, you can't you can be in relationships and try to do what you want to do, or you can't sit up here and put stigmas and say, well, this is what you need to do here and this is what you need to do that. And, you know what I'm saying? You can't sit here and you know, try to make yourself be something that you are not, if that makes any sense.
Taya, or a bi girl who now only likes trans men like Rio, they can't look like him. I know that's right. So you got everyone crushing. You got everyone crushing.
Listen, no. Sorry. But, you know, as far as the whole thing, I don't want to get upset. So, you know, I'm trying to, you know, I just want everybody to see it from everybody's point of view, because a lot of times the problem is that everybody don't see it from everybody's point of view, and they want to take their own point of view and run with it. And I just want people to be a little bit more understanding, you know what I'm saying, of people's lives and the situations that they go through, and understand that this is the reason why they like what they like, or whatever the case may be, because you're making a lot for their life if you just sit the fuck down and listen. You know what I'm saying? And that's what's wrong with people now. They don't want to sit down and listen. So, like, if you want to take anything from me, know that you need to be humble. You know what I'm saying? Know that you need to be humble, and know that you need to be understanding and listening, because something that makes sense to you might not make sense to me. And something that you may think is stupid, I don't think is stupid. So try to be a little bit more understanding of people's lives, situations, their transition, the journeys that they go through, or whatever the case may be, because the same smart-ass remarks, rude-ass comments, ignorant comments that you make, know that those comments will come back to haunt you.
I know that's right. You better look.
Whether it be that you go through something in your life and you lose everything, or whatever the case may be, know that those comments will come back.
Well, you have people that you're inspiring, which is the point of this whole live. And it's great that you get that, because I have someone that, Kalani said, it's crazy because I had sex with more gay studs and trans men than I've had straight women. I think gay females or studs or trans men rather have gay men anyway. I might be wrong, but Rio, you most def opened my eyes more, and now you're my future hubby.
Yeah, right.
What you're doing is Tisa, because sometimes people get confused of who they are themselves. And
because
they watch TV and they're on the internet and they see a guy and a girl or two gay guys or two girls, they see this typical stigma of what it should look like. And when they feel a different way, mm-hmm. they that's when depression comes in. That's when you lose yourself.
Yeah. But I'm gonna be honest with you though, King. It's okay to be confused. It's okay to be confused, because I'm gonna tell you right now, me personally, growing up, being that I was in the household and stuff that I was in, I'm not gonna sugarcoat no shit. I was a confused person. I didn't know if I wanted to have a boyfriend or a girlfriend or none of that. But because I have been through the situations that I have been through, I can honestly say that it's okay to question and go out here and try to figure out if this is your type or this is what you want to do or whatever the case may be, because me personally, I'm not going to learn no life lesson unless I do it.
You better preach to the kids. Congregation. Did you hear that? There you go, we had a pastor up here.
Because like my mama told me, you will go further in life shooting your shot than sitting back and watching everybody else shoot the shot for you.
Isis,
you know what I mean?
Isis, we can talk. Well,
congratulations to you.
We can talk, Isis, because I also do want to follow the life of a trans female, so that would be amazing for I'll inbox you to see if we can talk about some things. But guys, don't think this is the last you're gonna see of Rio, because we're gonna follow his life and follow his transition. So in a couple weeks,
every month,
you know, we'll do it again and see what's new, what he's experiencing, the new challenges, the new uplifting moments, the new everything. So I'm really excited for this journey that we're going to take. And I'm really thankful that you agreed to this, because I know this is not easy. You know, it's not easy.
It's not easy, but you know what I'm saying? When I am a friendly person and I'm a humble person and I'm very open to conversation, it makes it a lot easier for me. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, if I'm not going to tell it, who going to tell it, girl? Because it won't get told.
And that's the problem, people. And that's the thing why I want people to know. Even if it's an offensive conversation, I want people to take their sensitivity out, take their personal feelings out, and listen to the conversation, because the conversation is needed. And you feel uncomfortable. Sometimes you need to feel uncomfortable for change to happen. I'm a true believer in that. And even though this was an uncomfortable conversation,
It was a little bit, but you know what?
Look how many people, if you go to the comments, look how many people is inspired by this and has opened their eyes. And it's just that many less ignorant people out there now, because they got this little bit of information, you know?
Right. She says, I'm glad that you are being you. You have my support. I thank you so much, but I would have it no other way than to be myself, because, I mean, it's only one life to live. If you can't live your best life, then what you gonna do? What you gonna do, girl? Please tell me.
And you ain't lying. You gotta live your best life, because you're the only one that's gonna live it.
Right. Absolutely, Tanya, honey, child. Girl, don't get it twisted.
Yes. I love you, Sorio. So we're going to conclude this, guys, because I don't want to give too much information, because we still got another interview to do with Mr. Rio, and we're going to get more knowledge next month, month two of transition. This is going to be such an exciting journey. It's going to be an emotional journey. And we're just going to be raw and uncut and talking about all the questions. So get your questions ready. Thank you guys for engaging. Thank you guys for sharing. Thank you guys for interacting with this live.
Thank you for having me.
Of course.
And pushing me to my limit.
Shut up.
Because I know, you know what I'm saying? If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be doing this. But it also lets me know that it makes me thankful to know that, you know, there are people out here in the community that support me, even though you guys may not know me, or you may not talk to me, or I may not talk to you. It just feels good to know that, you know, I have people that support me and that are always watching, even if I am at my worst times, you know what I mean? So I really do appreciate everybody, you know, all the love and, you know, all the comments.
You know what, that's coming.
I'm not trying to make it
that comes from you. You know what? Because what they pick up on is your authenticity. What they pick up on is your genuinity. What they pick up on is your how sweet you are and how real you are and honest with you. So you could have been a whole nother way and everyone would have took this a whole nother way. But it's the person you are in the midst of all this, all the trial, all the error, all the accomplishments, all the success, all the love, all the hate, through all of that, you still are this humble person. And that takes a lot, and that takes strength to be who you are and to still right. smile about it. So thank you for that, because even though right. I'm not trans, it still puts me in the mindset of, I ain't got nothing to worry about, because, you know, you're going through all of this and still smiling. There's no reason why I can't. You feel me? Yeah. So shout yeah. out to you, for real, for real. Shout out to you. You're doing your numbers and keep shining.
Don't make me cry, child. Seriously.
And child, look, he at the gym. Then show me some, took a picture of his arms and stuff. Look.
Hello. Y'all no, let me tell
GQ
you.
GQ Magazine, I'm telling you.
Let me tell you, ever since that I started my transition, I have been in the gym every day, and I have said and set the record straight that I will go no other way but up, period. So
look, you got me church swaying. Look, that's that church.
I will go no other way but up. I don't give a fuck who is in my life, who walks out of it. I'm going up. I don't give a damn.
I know that's right.
Child, I'm going to be walking around. I'm going to be the next bodybuilder. You
hello?
Fuck with me.
Look. Hello? Look, and we're going to be on the whole journey there. We're going to be watching you as you go. So, look, thank you for coming on here. Next month, we'll schedule a date, and we'll get that to you guys so that y'all know can be prepared. This is going to be transferred to our YouTube channel. Make sure y'all go subscribe to The Royal Couch. DaRoyalCouch. Make sure y'all go follow Rio. And yeah. make sure, just show love, show support. And when you can, if you can, it's okay to drop in our DMs, in his DM, in anybody's DM that you know that needs that love and support. It's okay just to be like, I got you, I'm yeah. here, I love
and
you.
And I just want to say this real quick. To all the fellow trans women, men, people thinking about it, people have questions about it, don't be afraid to ask, because the worst thing that you could do is not ask. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to say that I'm going to reply to you right away, because I am currently busy and trying to get my life together as a personal human being, but I will try to help you out the best way that I can, even if it takes a conversation. You know what I'm saying? I'm sorry. I was laughing at women across the top of my screen. But even if it takes for me to have a personal conversation with you, like, I will have that conversation if you need it, because the last thing that I would want to do is see another fellow trans man or trans woman, you know, out here going through depression or trying to take themselves out or any of that, because they just don't know. Like, at the end of the day, there are other people that are going through worse things than you. So if you need somebody to talk to, just open your fucking mouth. That's all I'm saying.
I know that's right.
Just open your mouth.
Thank you guys for the love and support. Again, this is Rio Wave.
Alrighty.
I wish I had like a depression hotline or a hotline to put afterwards or something like that. I feel like,
child, you know, let me tell you something. You don't need no motherfucking depression hotline. All you need is one another.
Hello.
To deal with that.
You better stop preaching to the congregation. Look at you. Preaching to the Lord. Love you. Thank you for coming on. Guys, thank you guys for watching. All my royals, y'all are amazing. Thank you. Thank you all for our new royals coming up and that just learn about the show. We do episode season 4 will be coming up in the new year, but we're going to be doing random interviews here and go. But we are going to be following Rio's transition. And so next month we will have another interview. So make sure y'all stay tuned and watch out. We love you.
Word up. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. I'm about to get off this joint because I got to go to work in the morning at 7 o'clock. So I will be tuning in to you later.
Trans Lifeline, 1-877-565-8860. Again, the Trans Lifeline, 1-877-565-8860. make sure if you need support, you need help, to dial that number or just dial a friend, because that's all we need is each other.
Or if you don't want to spend no motherfucking money, just call somebody
Hello?
Else, child.
Look, call me. Maybe, maybe. No, you can call me. We love you guys. Thank you for tuning in. Until next time.
Peace.